Ringless honey.
对啊。
Different as they look, they are all honey mushrooms and are edible. Specifically, there are the three species of honey mushrooms that you're most likely to encounter in Northeast America. Today, I'm going to show you how to properly identify them and their poisonous lookalikes. Sit tight and get ready. Let's begin with Malaria tablets, aka the ringless honey mushrooms. They are the earliest honeys to appear in a year.Starting to pop up since mid-August. I usually find them during the pawpaw season. Back to topic, our Malaria tablets can take on different shades of brown, from beige to gold to dark tan, but they have things in common.First, they don't have a ring.Because they are ringless honeys, so the stem is bare. The cap can be a bit depressed in the center or even funnel-shaped. The gills are slightly decurrent, running down the bare stem. Second, they have white flesh, and I am talking about fresh, non-discolored specimens. Third, and most importantly, the spore print is white.Lay the mushroom on the surface for a couple of hours to allow the spores dropping. You'll always see white print for honeys. Fourth, they grow on stumps, under trees or near roots in clusters, and their feet are connected. So if you see some scattered little brown mushrooms growing from the grass with no wood nearby, they probably are not honeys.Except for the first characteristic regarding ring and gills, the rest of three features apply to all honeys. Ringless honeys can be relatively difficult to identify because their colors and shape vary, and they do not always have hairs on their stems or on the caps, which I consider is one of the key identifying features of honey mushrooms. This second honey is the prettiest and our favorite, Malaria Garlic.It appears slightly after the ringless honey. You can see them with the early hen of the woods, or maitake mushroom.
Isn't it beautiful?
Malaria Garlic can take on a stunning bright yellow color, although it can also be dull. Malaria Garlic is the easiest honey to identify, thanks to its distinct color and its prominent ring and hairs as well. The ring is the membrane that covers gills when the mushroom is young. Malaria Garlic has a white, thick, napkin-like ring which can stay on the stem when the mushroom matures instead of falling off. The hairs are very visible, especially on the center of the cap and towards the bottom of the stem.Like all honeys, they have white meat, white spore print, and growing clusters. But if you see this mushroom, bright yellow with a ring zone on the stem, growing in clusters from wood in fall, don't hasten to conclude it's Malaria Garlic. It's a lookalike, the foliota mushroom, often considered inedible, though some eat it.The foliota is covered by bigger scales, or spikes, instead of the finer hairs as with the honeys. The cap is slimy, the flesh is light yellow, and so the gills. As the mushroom ages, the gills will turn brown, which is also the color of its spores. There are other differences between the foliota and the honey.But these are enough for you to tell the two apart.
One possible poisonous lookalike to Malaria milia is the Czech lantern mushroom, which is bright orange in color. But if you remember all the features I just mentioned, there should be no confusion. Check the gills, stem, meat, and spore print of jack-o'-lantern. I bet you already see the difference from the honeys.
You might think jack-o'-lantern resemble the ringless honey, as both are ringless and have decurrent gills. But spore print is different. Plus, jack-o'-lantern usually appears much later of the year, so you probably won't see the two grow side by side. Still, if you'd like to learn more and to be very sure, click the link in the right corner, to familiarize yourself with jack-o'-lantern. Also, you can use our AI-powered free mushroom identification tool, Fungus ID. I will provide the link below in the description box.
Now, there is only one honey left on our list, and it is also the most dangerous one, Malaria garlica. Malaria garlica appears quite late, usually in mid-late fall. Also growing in this time include the hen of the woods, shrimp of the woods, bluet, and even lion's mane mushrooms. Malaria garlica has a web-like ring when it is young, which is very fragile and can come off. The ring can leave a ring zone on the stem of a mature specimen, or not. So don't judge the garlica by its ring. Instead, looking for the common features, hairs, white flesh, white spore print, and growing clusters. Bonus ID tips. The end of garlica stem usually have a yellowish tint. Malaria garlica is not necessarily hard to identify, but it can be very dangerous, because it has a deadly look-alike, deadly galerina, very toxic, as the name indicates. With its brown cap and ring zone, deadly galerina does resemble Malaria garlica a lot. The trick is, deadly galerina is very smooth, free from the hairs. Also, it is way flimsier. But to make sure, you always want to check the spore print. Galerina yields a brown print, just like its meat, whereas honeys have a white print. Okay, you already have all the information needed to correctly identify the three honey mushrooms. A quick recap of some shared features. White spore print, that's key. White meat, which can be tan sometimes. Hairs or scales on the stem, though not always discernible. Plus, they always grow near trees or on stumps in clusters. Focus on these traits and don't be distracted by some superficial characteristics, like the shape and color of the cap, gills, or hairs. These things can change with age and environment, but spore print won't. So what do you think? Is it easy or too hard to identify honey mushrooms? Honeys are not starter mushrooms, but it is quite interesting and easy to identify if you know what features to look for. But if you're new to mushroom hunting, I suggest you practice first. Try to find and compare carefully all the species I just mentioned before collecting them for consumption. For safety reasons, of course. Alright, thanks for watching this quick honey mushroom ID guide. I hope you enjoy it and learn things. See you next time. Bye.